So last classes we are discussing about ANECA MapReduce programming models. So today we're going to see that what is the ANECA MapReduce data file formats. If you see this diagram, we're going to discuss each and every information which is recorded here. This part is nothing else, it's a header information, because you are going to provide some extra bit of information. So whenever you are whenever processing data in the forms of MapReduce programming models, because when you're going to give any kind of input, that input must be converted into the key value pairs, because mappers will going to accept only the data in the forms of key value pairs with the help of record readers. The record readers will convert the input data into the form of key value pairs. And that is given to reducer. Reducer also going to process it and going to produce the key value pairs. So here the data will be represented in the forms of key value pair only. And here this part is going to represent the header information, which consists of 3 bytes. And if you're going to have numbers, which can hold 1 byte of information. And this part is nothing but it's a block part, record block, because in block only you're going to store the actual data. The actual data in we store in the forms of key value pairs here. So if you see this part, this contains the length of the block. So if you want to represent length of the block, which represent here, if you see this part will indicate the length of the blocks, which is about the 4 bits, 4 bits of the length of the blocks. And this will indicate about the length of the key. So length of the key and length of the block will be given in the forms of the integer format, which hold 4 bytes. And this length of the key, which holds about the 4 bytes. And this is actual data we are going to represent here, which in the forms of the key value pairs. So here the key value pairs will be represented in the forms of byte array, and value also represented in the forms of the byte array here. Now we know that this key value pairs always in the forms of that is key and value pair. Suppose if I am going to write a program for the word count programs, right, to count number of words in a given text. In this sense, I am going to call as the key may be, see, the key may be, suppose cat is a key and value is 1. It means the cat appears only 1 time in the given text. If I am going to write like the dog, and if I am going to write 3, it means the dog is going to call as key and it appears 3 in the text. So it means here we are representing the data how in the forms of the key value pairs value. So this is the actual data formats we are using here in ANECA. The ANECA will provide you the implementation of the MapReduce programming model. So with the help of the ANECA middleware, it support to run the MapReduce applications with the help of the ANECA middleware services. Now you are going to see the next important concern topic here is the cloud platform services, because the cloud is going to provide different types of services for the developers and for the vendors, for the manufacturers, or if you want to develop or deploy a distributed applications, we can use a wide variety of the cloud platform services. So first we're going to see about what are the different types of cloud platform services are available. The first we'll discuss about the Amazon Web Services in details, that why we require Amazon Web Services and why we are more concerned about the Amazon Web Services, and how Amazon Web Services will support you to deploy and to create a distributed applications environment. So let me give you a brief idea about this topics, that how it's going to help the users to develop these services, which is called as what services? The Amazon Web Services, AWS. Okay. Now, why we require Amazon Web Services? Because the Amazon Web Services has the many features. It has many features. The first features I can call that it has a features of flexibility, right? It's a features of the flexibility is the important features of the Amazon Web Services. Okay. And it is also the features of the cost effective. It is more cost effective features it has. Cost effective. Then it is the features of scalability. It has the features of what? It has the features of scalability. And one most important features of Amazon Web Services is what? It has features of the security. The security is most important features of what? The features of the Amazon Web Services. Now, why you require Amazon Web Services? This is the first question it may hit your mind, right? See, suppose let me take a small use cases. Now I want to start a companies. Okay, I want to start companies and I want to deploy an applications. Right, I want to deploy applications to the server. So if I want to deploy an application, so first what I did, I create an application. The applications I want deployed, so I need many servers, right? I need to maintain many servers because I'm going to handle many clients who can request my services. So if I want to maintain a server, I have to go and buy it, and for that I have to invest a lot of money, and I don't have that much of money to buy buy infrastructures like a server, because server is not an easy task that you can buy within 10 rupees or 20 rupees. It requires huge amount of money, and if the questions of buying more than one servers, then you have to invest more money for that. So I have to I have to buy the servers, and after buy the servers, my work has not been completed yet, because I need to maintain the server. The maintenance cost also be very big issues, very concern. I have to maintain server, and also if many clients are increasing, then I have to see how my servers are handling the client request, right? So we have to see the load balancing, how the load balancing will be taking care of it. That is also the one important concern. And one more important concern is about the security. How I'm going to provide security to my clients, because they are going to access my services, they are going to use my application. So I have more concern about the security issue also. So as a startup of my companies, I cannot have that much of money to buy and to set up this huge infrastructures. Then how I can run my show, how I can run my organizations. So in these cases, the Amazon Web Services is going to help me. The Amazon Web Services will tell me that I will provide all kind of services what you want, and you use my services, and in return you pay what services you are using. So if I use services for 1 hour, for 1 hour basis, I pay for 1 hour services for Amazon Web Services. If I use the services around 2 hours, I have to pay for 2 hours service only. So this is just like a pay and use services you are going to provide. So here, instead of investing a money of millions of dollars, right, to set up the infrastructures in the organization, what I can do is that I can avail the services of Amazon Web Services, and I can do a lot of stuff on it. I can deploy applications, and I can free about this concern. I should just think about my business values. So everything everything headache will be given to the Amazon Web Services. The Amazon Web Services is going to manage my servers, is going to manage my data, keep my data in more secure manner, and he will try to maintain security of my applications data also. So it means that I have no business about the maintenance of servers. I have no business about how to handle the clients. I have no business about how to handle the load balancing. Everything is taken care of by the Amazon Web Services. So that's why nowadays Amazon Web Services is becoming very famous to deploy my applications, to distribute the application. So many developers are using it. It's helping the developers to develop in applications at very fast, at very rapid speed, at very quick, fast speed, we can develop in applications. So that's why the Amazon Web Services is one of the important services which is famous around the globe. So these are the important features we can find here. One feature is called flexibility. Yes, it's very flexible for the developers. Suppose if I need operating system, different types of operating system, Amazon Web Services will provide to me. It's very flexible for the users. I need different programming languages. I want to work in different programming languages. So this kind of environment the Amazon Web Services can provide. I can use, I can scale up and scale down as per my requirement. I can scale up my server, I can scale down my server as per the requirement of my applications. So it provides a service of flexibility. How much requirement I have, this much of services, I will get it from the Amazon Web Services. So for that, I should just pay for that. So it provides services for the flexibility. I can have a different types of operating system as per my requirements. I can have a different types of service as per requirements. I can use different types of services as per my requirements. So this is called as what flexibility level what is be given by the Amazon Web Services. And the second thing is going to call is very cost effective. Let me give you a real time example about cost effectiveness. I want to visit Delhi, okay, to write an entrance examination or to appear in a UPSC examination, to appear in Union Public Service Commission examination. And for that, I have to go and attend interview at Delhi. Now, my question is that I'm going to stay there around 1 day. It means I can stay 24 hours. There is my time frame that in that 24 hours, I need to complete my interview sessions. Now, for to stay 24 hours, what is my alternative, how I can stay there. Will I buy a house to stay there for 24 hours? Because I'm going to stay there only for 24 hours. So will you recommend me to buy a big house? So I'll buy a big house, I'll go there, I'll stay in my house comfortably. I can interview and I'll come back. That's one thing. Second, will you recommend me to take an option to stay in hotels? I will go and stay in hotels for 24 hours. So I can use the services of the hotels of 24 hours. Whatever services I can go into avail for the hotels. The hotels will give me some kind of services like breakfast services, or I can take restroom. So whatever services provided by the hotels, I will enjoy it. And for 24 hours only, I'm going to pay that amount. So which option is the best one? Obviously, if you see, buying the house is very costly affairs, because we cannot buy a house just like paying 200 rupees or paying 1000 rupees. Not possible. You have to pay in the terms of lakhs to buy a house. But paying hotels in the terms of 1000 rupees possible, in the terms of 600 rupees also possible, depends upon your ability of your cost effectiveness ability. So if I have 100 rupees, I can go for merely a very third class hotel. If I have 600 rupees, I can go merely a good class hotel. So depends upon my capability. I can avail hotel services. I can use it for 24 hours. Once my work has been done, I'll come out to my place. So this is going to call as cost effective service. In same way, the Amazon Web Services also provided services. So if you want any kind of services, just use it for a while, pay it for a while and come out. Suppose I want the services from the Amazon that I need server for only for 24 hours. I will pay the amount for that server configuration. For that server, I use it and I complete my work, then I will pay for that much of time only. So these Amazon Web Services are very much cost effective. So if I want to use, I want to store data, if I want to store object instance, I can avail the services, store it, use it, and I'll pay the money for that. If I want to do some computing services, I will take the server with high configurations, I'll perform computations, I'll do it, and I return that one, I'll pay for that. So it means pay and use services. Who is going to provide you? Is going to provide you Amazon Web Services. So here the Amazon Web Services will have a more cost effective for the end user and for the developers. So if I'm a developer, I can avail the services from the Amazon, I can use for a while, I can deploy my applications. And for that, I will pay whatever I use it. That is the beauty of Amazon Web Services, which can provide a very cost effective scenarios. The third is called as scalability. Yes, the scalability is very important thing, because see, if my requirement has been increased, okay, my data set is very huge and I want to run it parallelly, or I want to use more number of system for computations, I want to use high servers for computations, I can scale up, I can use more number of instances, I can use more number of object instances, I can request more number of servers as per my requirement. So I can scale up. If I feel that my requirement has been shrinking, or my requirement is very less, I can sync up my requirements, I can use less number of instances, object instances, I can avail the services. So depending upon the requirement, I can request and I can avail the services. So there is flexibility of scaling up and there is flexibility of scaling down. So I can scale up and scale down based on my requirements. That is going to call as what? A scalability service, what, which is given by the Amazon Web Services. And the most important concern is what about the security? Okay, so how we are going to provide a security? Because as a service provider, you are a service provider, so you have to concern about my data, because my data should be much secure in your database, in your cloud services. So for that, the Amazon Web Services will provide you a data encryption. So he will take care of your data in more secure manners. He will encrypt your data. It will keep you in security so that the third party or any unauthorized people cannot access your data, cannot access your sensitive data. So your data will be much secure in Amazon Web Services. That's why the Amazon Web Services will take guarantees that whatever data you are giving to them, that will be remain secure forever and forever as per your requirements. So they will take your data in a more secure manner, and they'll keep data in a more secure manner. This is the important features of Amazon Web Services. So because of these features, the Amazon Web Services are ruling the ruling the world, and many companies are using the Amazon Web Services to deploy many applications, and they are using the different types of services which can provide Amazon Web Services. So Amazon Web Services is nothing else, it's a secured cloud platform service. You can call it secured cloud platform services. Okay, so it is a highly secure cloud platform services that is called as what? Amazon Web Services. Now we're going to discuss in details about what are the types of services that Amazon will going to provide to the organization or to the vendors or to the developers. Basically, it can provide the computational services where you can compute the huge data sets, where you can perform a computation on the huge data sets. So computational service can provide by the Amazon Web Services. It can provide you the storage services where you can store the bulk amount of data, where you can store the big data, where you can store the huge amount of massive amount of data which is being generated for your companies. Then It also provide you as some kind of communication services, right? You can communicate like email services, which can provide you. It can provide simple mail services. It can provide you simple notification services. It can provide you simple queue services. So there are different types of communication services that the Amazon Web Services provide. It provides a virtual networking services by using virtual private cloud, by using Amazon Virtual Network Cloud, by using Amazon Direct Connect Cloud Computing Networking Services. So there are too much services that the Amazon will provide you for the establishment of the communications of the networks. So the Amazons are doing well in all the areas, and they are providing a lot of flexibility. They are providing a lot of resources to the vendors, the companies, for the organization to develop and to deploy in applications. So it's now because of the cloud computing services, the people are not worrying about infrastructures, because they are the one who will take care of the infrastructure. They will take care of the security. They will take care about the communication. They will take care about your cost effectiveness. They will calculate the money, how much you need to pay, how much service they are going to provide you. So the burden has given to the third party. They are the one who are going to monitor and perform the and provide resources to you. Thus, you have to develop an applications by using their services. So basically, we know that we have three types of services that the cloud computing are providing. That is our SaaS, PaaS, and IaaS, right? SaaS, nothing but it's called a software as services. PaaS means platform as services. IaaS means it's going to call infrastructure services. So this kind of services that cloud is going to provide, and here the Amazon Web Services is one of the important platform where you can get all kind of services. And here we will discuss in details about the Amazon Web Services one by one, right? So hope you understand about the needs of the Amazon Web Services, that how the Amazon Web Services are getting famous here. So likewise, we have many services which can provided by the different companies, right? This Amazon Web Services is provided by the Amazon companies. Likewise, we have Google Cloud Platform services which can provided by the Google companies. We have Microsoft services, that is Microsoft Azure, is what is provided by the Microsoft company. So this Microsoft Azure is kind of cloud computing services what is being provided by the Microsoft companies. So these are the three topmost companies, we can say that they are bounded to provide you the cloud computing services. And so for we are going to discuss one by one in details that about the Amazon Web Services, cloud computing services, and Microsoft Azure services. So let me first discuss about the Amazon Web Services here. Now you see here in this contents we are going to discuss the three important services provided by three companies in the cloud area. That is, one is Amazon Web Services, that is AWS. Second is Google App Engine, which can provide by the Google companies to develop applications, to develop in website applications, so you can say. And Microsoft Azure, which can provide by the Microsoft companies. Now you are going to see here this Amazon services here. This Amazon services will provide you the three important services in ecosystems, you can say. That the first one is called as the compute services. The second one is called as the storage services. And the third one is going to call as the communication services. So these are three important services that the Amazon is going to provide you for the developers and for the end users and for the companies. And here I give you some details that you can find a lot of information about Amazon services. So that link is given to you and you can use it for more descriptions and for the sessions. Now coming to the here this compute services, we have different types of compute services are provided by the Amazons. These compute services are basically used to perform a computations, to perform a computation of the large data sets, to perform a some kind of computations and to get the results. And for the processing, we have to use a huge server. You have to use a huge storage services, right? You use a huge power of machines where you can do some kind of computations. So here they have a different types of compute services available, like AMI. We have ES2 instance, that is elastic computing services, elastic computing environment, advanced computing services like AWS Elastic Beanstalk or AWS Cloud Amazon Elastic MapReduce. So these are MapReduce, already we are discussing that will be provided by Anika, and that will going to also to process the large data sets. So if you want to do processing for large data sets, we have to use MapReduce application model also. So here this kind of computing services are somewhat costly affairs because it's do a lot of computations on your applications and it can provide you the results whatever you require. So here you need a high configuration of system, you need a GPU to process the huge data sets. So here you're going to see about one by one about the compute services. So this will show you the Amazon compute, what are the different types of Amazon compute services available. So first one we see about the virtual machine. The virtual machine here, what is the use case for virtual machine? Number one, the sequence and resizable compute capacity virtual servers in the cloud. It means we can access the virtual servers, right, from the clouds. Because you see, you ask question of what is mean of the resizable. The resizable in the sense that you can increase the server or you can decrease the server depend upon the requirement of your service. Just like elastic. What is the elastic characteristic? You can increase the length of the elastics as you need. You can decrease the length of the elastic as you require. Similarly, here also, as per the need of the server, we can demand the server. If you need more number of servers for competitions, you can request more number of servers within 2 to 3, 4 clicks. We'll get more number of servers. If you want a less number of servers, you can decrease or shrink the size of the server. So it's just like a resizing of computing capacities. That's important. So virtual machine is available, right? You can access servers. You can access the servers from the remote machines, from the remote services. Easy to use cloud platform that offers you everything you need to build application or website. So if you want to build an application over the website, you can avail this kind of services. Virtual machines is available for you, and by using virtual machines, we can build an application or you can build our services. So to provide virtual machines services, we have Amazon Web Services domain, right? We have different domains available in Amazon Web Services, and the two important famous domains are Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud Domains, which is called as EC2, Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud Domains, and second one is called as the Amazon Light Cell Services. So these are two important services where you can avail the virtual machine services, and through that we can develop an applications or website. Coming to the next one, containers. You know, see that containers means what? We are going to access the resources for your development, right? You need some CPU, you need some RAM, we need some kind of storage capacity, you need some disk. So we need to have a containers to run applications. So here this, it provides high secure, reliable, scalable way to run containers. So easily store, manage and deploy containers image. So you can easily access containers, you can easily maintain containers, you can store something on the containers and fully manage Kubernetes services. So here the Kubernetes services can be also be available. So to provide a containers more effectively and more prominently for the developers and for the end user, this Amazon will bring a lot of good services like that Amazon Elastic Container Services that will going to provide you containers, and through that we can deploy and you can store, you can manage images also, and you can also available also you can also manage Kubernetes services, and we can run containers. And also we have Amazon Elastic Containers Registry, that is also important services for the containers. And third is called Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Services. This is the third categories of services for the containers. So this, the containers kind of services, who can provide? The Amazon Web Services will provide it for the developers. Coming to third one, serverless. Serverless doesn't mean that you don't have server. Yes, you have a server, but it should be in virtual machine. It should be in virtual. It's virtual imagination. Servers will be here, the server else, and you're accessing services, right? So there should not be any kind of you should not be thinking anything about the servers, right? You just run the code, you'll get the results. So here, that run code without thinking about server. So you run the code, you don't think about server, who can maintain the server, what is configuration of the server, how the servers are working, how my data will be secure, how the servers are going to run my application. Don't think about that. You should be free from all kind of headache, all kind of tension, all kind of worries, all kind of woeful experience. Just run the code and get the things done. So here, run code without thinking about servers, pay only for the compute time you consume. So just pay, suppose you use for 1 hour, pay money for 1 hour. Suppose you use for 2 hours, pay money for 2 hours. Suppose you use for 3 hours, pay only for 3 hours. Depending upon uses, we are paying the money for the services. And serverless compute for containers. And they will also provide you containers where we can manage, maintain, and we can do a processing with the help of the container also. And for that, serverless services that our MSS will bring up, the domains services like the AWS Lambda services is available and AWS Fragate services available in Amazon. And we can avail these services to access a server. And you can run the huge code and you can get the computation results with a fraction of a second. But then, and edge and hybrid, this is another types of category you're having, that it can provide a run AWS infrastructures and service on premises for a truly consistent hybrid experience. If you want to have a hybrid experience, mixed experience, that you are going to use different types of data, and if you want to use different types of technologies, and you want to develop an applications by using different types of hybrid technology, and for that they will provide you this kind of hybrid infrastructure for the developers. And here you can have the hybrid experience. You can have the you can use more than two technology to run and to create and to run the applications. And for that, this Amazon Web Service will provide like AWS Fragate and AWS Outposts. So these are the important services that you can avail in the Amazon for the computations. Coming to here, Dellville ultra low latency application for 5G devices. So if you want to using like some kind of 5G mobile devices, and if you want to have very high speed applications, if you want to have high speed applications, you can use that AWS Wavelength services. And also for rapidly extends migrate protect your VMware environment to the AWS cloud. So if you want to secure your virtual machine environment to the AWS cloud, and for that you have to use VMware cloud on AWS. For that you can also access VMware environment, and also you can migrate or you can store and use data on AWS clouds. Now coming to the next important features here is that cost and capacity management. So how the Amazon Web Services are going to provide you a more cost and effective management for the developers and for the end users. The first one is run fault tolerant workload for up to 90% of off. It means you should not worry about the load balancing. The load balancing will be taken care by the AWS, right? So whatever the load, whatever the, how many clients are requesting your services, how the servers are going to balance the load, everything should be taken care by the Amazon Web Services. That's what I call is the fault tolerance. And if one server is failed to work, then they're going to reinitiate another service. Okay. So they're going to have a replication factors. They're going to have the secondary servers, or the standby server. So they provide the services for you. Available services is always available into 24/7. And here, at very end, remove compute capacity to meet changes in demand. So suppose if your demand is high, so you can add more number of computer. If demand is less, we can reduce number of computer, just like Elastic, right? Because see, if I want to run a huge application, I need more number of server. Yes, I can go and add more number of servers. Suppose if you want to add less number of server, if required, I can use less number of machines. So just like we have like Elastics, I can shrink, I can resize based on the capacity of my work. Next is full managed batch processing at any scale. So it can provide you the batch processing. Means if you have a huge data for one day, you store data for this day, you can process next day. You store data for the next day, you process third day. So it means it also support batch processing environment, just like a Hadoop environment we are having. So if you want to have a data and if you want to do the batch processing, it can provide you batch processing scalability also. And recommends optimals the AWS compute resource from your workload to reduce cost and improve performance. So here it is going to ask you only the money for that use the services. They won't ask you extra money for that. And also they want to improve the performance of the system. So you shouldn't worry about the performance. You should not worry about the security. Everything is concerned about the Amazon Web Services. Okay. And for that, they can provide you an AWS Compute Optimizer. What is use of the optimizer is what? To improve the performance of the system. So if you want to improve the performance of the system, they can use you, they can give you this kind of services, right? Also. And easy to use services for deploy scaling web application service. So if you want to deploy web application services, you can use what? You can use AWS Elastic Beanstalk. So these are the important services that you can use for the deploying and scaling web application services also. And next one is called build and maintain secure Linux for Windows Server images. So if you want to build and maintain secure Linux or Windows Server images, and for that the images will provide you important domain services which is called ES2 image builders. And similarly, we have automatically distributed incoming application traffic across multiple targets. So to maintain load balances between the different servers and between different machines, they can provide you services which is called as elastic load balancing services. So these are different types, categories of services available which can provide by the Amazon services. So this is what you are talking about, the Amazon computing services. And in the next class we will discuss about the storage services in detail. So thank you very much.